Mini chapter 24, Amber stalks Ashley through the motel by LAX. A moment after Ashley's car emerges from under the Avenue of the Stars tower, Amber's pulls away from the curb at its waiting place across Constellation Boulevard and falls into leisurely pursuit. Whistling a soft tune through his teeth, Amber narrows his eyes while she's turning right onto Century Park West ahead of him, in an effort to afford himself and Jaymi a glimpse of Ashley's profiled face in her driver's side mirror as she turns. When the 405 freeway bridge appears ahead, Amber gets into the southbound lane, two cars behind her. He squints into the sun as they both emerge from the shade beneath the 405 and curve left, one after the other, off Santa Monica Boulevard and onto the ramp. Up on the concrete space of the freeway, he keeps her in easy view ahead, passing under the 10 and onward a few miles down the west side. She slides into lane for the Florence Avenue exit, and with curiosity he tails her off the freeway and onward a mile or so, ending in the parking lot of a faceless motel by LAX, near the perimeter of the airport, somewhere around Aviation and West Century Boulevards. Ashley locks her car and sets off through this place of blandest transience. She crosses the lot to the motel entrance. At a well-judged distance, Amber follows. Inside is a wide, impersonal lobby. She sets off across it, heading not for the check-in desk, but for a fast food outlet in the far corner. Enough people are dotted about to allow him to stand within earshot of her without attracting notice while she waits in line at the food counter, clenching her jaw. At last she reaches the front of the queue, where she orders a salad to take away. He picks up a magazine from a seat and flips through it, cognizant, all the while, of the uptight clenching, clenching, clenching of Ashley Tweak's jaw while she waits for her food. Once equipped with her takeaway bag, she recrosses the lobby's expanse and exits the motel, followed by him. She walks to her car, as he does to his. She gets in, locks the doors and sits there chewing, while he watches her from behind the tinted windows of his car 50 meters away, whistling a tune between his teeth. When she starts the car and exits the lot, Amber follows. She drives along Century and all around the northern edge of the airport. At its far northwest corner, she turns left onto the deserted highway of Pershing Drive. Then after about 600 meters, she does the last thing he expects, which is slow down, pull over on the right, and come to a stop here in the middle of nowhere. There would be no way Amber could stop too without arousing suspicions in her that she was being followed. He therefore drives on, slowing his speed a little, and peering into his side mirror for just about long enough to allow himself and Jaymi to register that she has parked in the entrance of a fenced-off side road. Climbing a gentle slope of scrubby dirt, the side road is surfaced but has no structures on either side. Just a dead, open space between an airport and an ocean, with nobody around.